With the Tokyo Revengers anime coming to a close, I'm sure that some of you have already hopped on the bandwagon on reading the manga, and probably noticed a few key differences to the anime's adaptation of the manga that even the uncensored version of the anime didn't show. How's it going, everyone? It's your host, Andrew Schatz here, and today we'll be going over some of the differences between the Tokyo Revengers anime and manga. Before starting, I would like to inform you guys that I'll be splitting this video into two parts, as I believe it's too much information to fit into one video. Without further ado, let's get into it. During the first couple pages of the first chapter, we see Takemichi slashing the side of a car with a coin. In which the anime version, we saw a bunch of kids slashing the car and framing it on Takemichi. Before the release of the Tokyo Revengers manga, Hina's initial character design had long black hair, but soon after changed it to short hair and switched up a different hair color for the serialization of the first chapter. When Takemichi went back to the past, we saw him and his group of friends walking in the streets of Shibuya straight after departing the train, while in the anime we saw them stopping by a burger joint after departing. In a flashback, we see a panel of Takemichi alone after graduating, while in the anime version showed him going the opposite direction to his friends while mentioning that soon after graduating middle school, he quote-unquote escaped and alluded that that was the last time he saw them. After Takemichi and his pals were brutally beaten by the Kiyomasa gang, we see Takemichi getting on a train alone and immediately dash towards Hina's apartment, while in the anime he did so well around his group of friends. After Takemichi leaves Hina's apartment, we see a scene where both Takemichi and Hina look back at each other, while this didn't happen in the manga. After Takemichi threatened and scared away a few thugs that were harassing Nayoda with a broken glass bottle, he tossed it to the side, and we see Nayoda pointed out to Takemichi that it could be dangerous leaving it there, and therefore saw a cameo of the broken glass bottle in the bag, while this scene never happened in a manga. Well, in the present timeline, Nayoda was feeding Takemichi information about the Maji gang, and was quickly glossed over the fact that Nayoda was a well-informative detective, while in the anime expanded upon the fact that Nayoda desperately wanted to be assigned under the Tokyo Maji gang case for months, until he finally received the position, and mentioned that his predecessor before him went undercover and was killed by the Tokyo Maji gang when he was caught. In Takemichi's school bathroom, we see Yamamoto preventing Yamagishi from touching him after he forgot to wash his hands, while in the manga, he never attempted to pat his shoulder. After Takemichi's fight against Kiyomasa, Akun stated that he was tempted to stab Kiyomasa, but never showed any signs of doing so, while in the anime clearly showed Akun's intention of stabbing him. Also during their fight, in the manga, we were shown a few panels of the spectators giving props to Takemichi, saying something along the lines of, "Why would he go this far?" and showed the crowd slowly going from cheering to silence. When both Mikey and Draken came to pick up Takemichi, we could see Draken was about the same size as the doorframe, but in the manga, we could see Draken was towering over it and even had to lean a little to see the inside of the classroom. And Draken isn't even that tall, standing almost 6'1" or 185 centimeters. Also, fun fact, most old-fashioned Japanese schools that were built during the 1920s or 30s or before World War II used to have smaller sized doors, as majority of the male population used to have the average height of 5'3" or 160 centimeters, while the female population was 4'11" or 100 centimeters during that time. So if Takemichi's school was built during that time period, it makes more sense to why Draken was towering over the doorframe. Also, the scene where Hina slapped Mikey, we could see shoeboxes had doors with them, while in the manga, they did not. Another thing to point out is when Hina told off the kids about them being too loud as the train was jam-packed, whilst in the anime, on the other hand, wasn't jam-packed, but some people were still standing anyways, and regardless, Hina still told them off, even though the old lady could have just sat anywhere else. Also, I've never seen this amount of people standing on either a subway or on a train like this when there's so many open seats available unless the train is about to stop. Maybe the seats were that uncomfortable, or it could be because I'm an ignorant American that doesn't know any better, and maybe the Japanese public has a different way of viewing sitting on trains. When Hina was trying to rush her mother out of the door, we see Takemichi commenting that Hina's mother was as good looking as her. In the anime, we were shown a scene of Takemichi's room full of trash, while in the manga was even worse, and probably had some maggots or small animals living inside his room. After Akun jumped off to his death in front of Takemichi, we see Kazaki hanging out in the background at the rooftop, while in the manga we do not see him at the rooftop, but instead seemingly was on the ground when this occurred. In the following chapter, we are cut into a scene where we saw Takemichi moping as he doesn't have enough money to pay for his rent, while this scene was cut out in the anime. After what Hina found out what Takemichi was doing with Emma, we were shown a scene of Emma suddenly having a bat in her hands, while in the anime this was cut out. And speaking of the anime, we see Takemichi getting an even worse beating from Hina compared to the manga. Also, something interesting that I like the anime did here is introducing some of the Tomen captains such as Angry and Baji, who in the manga we didn't get to see until Tomen's brawl against Mobius. To add, we are shown characters that were foreshadowed such as Chifuyu and Hakai, as we didn't see Chifuyu in the manga until it was seen he was getting beaten up by Baji. As for Hakai, to avoid spoilers, he didn't make an official appearance until the early stages of the potential second season of Tokyo Revengers. When the name Mobius was brought up in Toma's meeting, we see a scene where Drake and told Mitsuya to explain the conflict between Mobius and after Peon and Pachin kicked Takemichi from behind. Well, in the anime, this was sort of moved around. After the meeting started, Takemichi was almost immediately kicked from behind, and it wasn't until Mitsuya came by to calm the situation down and told Takemichi of the whole situation of Mobius. When it was explained that Peon's closest friend was jumped by Mobius gang members and was forced to watch the Mobius gang doing horrible things to his girlfriend, we were actually showed a panel of what unfolded, which I won't show in this video, but if you'd like to see for yourself, it happened in chapter 11, or if I'm not mistaken, happened in the second volume of Tokyo Revengers. And for obvious reason, the scene was cut out completely in the anime version. Also, we were cut into the scene where, again, we're introduced to characters that were not introduced until way further down the line. For example, had the Tokyo Revengers anime stuck exactly to the manga, we wouldn't see a cameo of some of these characters until around episode 35 to 40, and we were shown a cameo of them in episode 5. After that meeting, we were shown a scene where Hina was still with Takemichi, even though this didn't happen in the manga, and why would that scene even happen anyways when she had supposedly left before the meeting even began? In episode 6, we were shown Takemichi suddenly in the future without an explanation, while the manga, on the other hand, we were shown a scene where Takemichi went to Naoto's house and showed hands with him. When Takemichi and Naoto paid a visit to Osanai in the future, we are shown a scene where Osanai said, "If Draken had never died, I," and he just walked off, while in the manga, he was cut off when his boss called him. Rewinding back, when Pachon was punched by Osanai, he landed on his back, while in the manga, he landed on his front. Also in the manga, we see a couple of the Mobius gang members to be slightly tanned, similar to Kazaki, but in the anime, they were not. Why is that? I have no idea. To help clear up on why some of the Mobius gang members were tanned, my guess is they were following along a trend called Goguru, and to save myself of a long explanation, here's a quick Google search on what a Goguru is. And if you can be bothered reading all that, it's essentially a trend where mostly younger women dyed their hair either orange or blonde and tanned themselves. But some men did this as well, and possibly why some of the Mobius gang members were tanned. When Hina walked up to Takemichi and Emma's quote unquote moment, we see Hina was wearing a yellow plain dress, while in the manga she was wearing a dress with stripes on it. And if you took a closer look, you could see the window behind them is open, while in the anime it was closed. In the manga, we were shown a panel where Takemichi and his crew were discussing that Pachin was arrested when Yamagishi, not this Yamagishi, this Yamagishi brought up the fact that Mobius was completely destroyed, and this whole scene was cut out in the anime. When Draken stopped by to visit Takemichi, we see he had to lean a little, while in the manga he was towering over that door. I'm not sure if Draken was meant to be taller or if the house is really old, but again, 6'1" or 185 centimeters isn't that tall, or at least compared to us in the West. When Takemichi and his gang were playing soccer or football, on how the rest of the world says it, we were shown a panel in the manga where Takemichi said something along the lines of, "Sorry, Naota, I deserve a little reward." And earlier, we see Takemichi's friends having a little too much fun playing it in the sand. During the festival, we see Emma's and Hina's kimono look a bit different compared to the manga, as... Who is calling me? Oh, you gotta be joking me. During the festival, we see Emma's and Hina's kimono look a bit different compared to the manga, as in the manga, they added a little bit more detail with more flowers and roses in their kimono. When Takemichi was caught by one of the Kiyomasa crew members, he was beaten and tied up with duct tape in the middle of the rain, while in the manga, he took a little bit more of a beating in his face. Alright, now for the real reason why I brought this scene up. Because why would you duct tape someone while it was raining out? Surely Takemichi could have broken free from all the rain that was pouring down. And if you're gonna put in the effort of tying him up in the middle of the rain, at least tie him up in a tree, or throw him under a tree, or heck, even throw him under that Mika house in the background to make it more believable. After Draken was ambushed by the Mobius gang members, we see Draken surrounded, and in the manga, Draken was even more bloodier in his head, and we see some of Mobius gang members with a baseball bat and another with a metal pipe. Also, if you notice, some of them were tanned, while in the anime, again, they are not. During Tomen's brawl against Mobius, we see some of the Tomen gang members getting some spotlight, characters such as Baji, Chifuyu, Hakai, and a few others. When Mikey confronted Peon and tried to talk Gojutsu him, in the background we see a few Mobius gang members just watching them, while in the manga people were just fighting around them instead. When Draken was stabbed, he was alone in an empty area, while in the manga he was in the middle of a brawl where people around them were going at it. Also, we did see some action between Hama and Mikey, and even saw some of them exchanging blows, compared to the manga where everything was off screened. In Takemichi's fight against Kiyomasa, we see Takemichi, I guess, juked around him and climbed onto his back and proceeded to choke him, while in the manga Takemichi just climbed onto his back when he bit him. When the ambulance came, we saw the medics spray right behind Emma and Hina, while this didn't happen in the manga. After Tomen's victory over Mobius, we see Mucha helping Angry walk with his usual serious look, while in the manga, he looks to be surprisingly smiling. For some of you that don't know, Mucha always had a serious look on his face, and to see him smiling is sort of interesting, even though I believe he did smile before in the anime. When we were cut into Hanma and Mikey, we see both of them knack at each other, and we could see some of Tomen's and Mobius gang members in the background, while in the manga, there are a lot more of them. Also, we see a Mobius gang member came to pick up Hanma in his motorcycle, and in the manga, he had a little tan on him compared to the anime that completely whitewashed him. Also, if I'm not mistaken, this is the only time we've ever seen him, as I don't remember seeing this character again after this chapter. In the anime, we were cut right into this scene where Draken was rushing to the emergency room, while in the manga, we did see him getting out of the ambulance vehicle. Also, we were shown a panel of a doctor saying they shouldn't give up hope, while this was cut out in the anime to probably give it a more suspenseful moment. When Mikey walked in, he tried to cheer up the gang by saying everything will be alright while standing. While in the manga, he was sitting down when he was cheering them up. After Draken's surgery was a success, we were cut into a scene where we saw the first years was bound toward Takamichi when he was walking by, and even some of the Tomen gang members actually talked to him, and for whatever reason, the anime just cut these two scenes out. Later, we were cut into between Takamichi's talk with Mikey, and as we could see, the background in the anime is vastly different compared to the manga version, as the manga showed much more detail and structures compared to the anime version. After Takamichi left the hospital, we were shown a panel where we saw Mikey, Draken, and Akun's face in the sky. And funny enough, this scene sort of reminded me of a scene in part 3 of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, where we saw a scene similar to this, and it's a shame that the anime cut this scene out. And that concludes everything I have to show for you guys in today's video. And if this video hits, 20 likes, I'll cover the rest of it in the Valhalla arc. Anyways guys, if you'd like to see more future Tokyo Revengers content, hit that subscribe button. Thanks for watching, I'll see you guys next time. Peace out.